I'm Larry Bobka. This is Danny Ferrell. We're both master fitters here at Second Swing. And we want to talk a little bit about one of the issues that comes up a lot. We get a lot of questions online about is, if I'm a higher handicapper, should I get fit for golf clubs? And I'm not going to speak for Danny, but usually I will anyway. But the answer to that is definitely yes. You definitely want to come in and get fit for golf clubs because it's going to help you. Most of the higher handicappers tend to not play that much golf. Some do, but some don't. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're playing once a month in your company scramble, you want to go out there. You need something in your golf bag that you're not going to struggle with. I mean, I've got three irons here. I've got a Lynx blade, a Titleist T100, and a Titleist T300. If you can see, there are big differences in these golf clubs, okay? There is no help from this blade iron. We better practice a lot. We better hit a lot of golf balls. Little bit more help from the T100. The T300 is going to give you a lot of help. It's got a wider sole. It's got a more forgiving face. It's going to create more ball speed. It's going to help you play better. So along with that, Danny's going to talk a little bit about some of the fittings, some of the things that he's seen working with players on how to help a high handicapper play better golf.
So one of the things we see often, guys come in, gals come in, maybe I don't belong here, Larry. I don't know if I'm a tour pro. Every ball goes a different direction when I'm out there. Why should I get fit? How
because
can it help?
We have things to help you. Ew. We have things to help because there are different designs, there are different models, just like I showed earlier. You need to have the appropriate club in your golf bag, okay? One of the things, I've had a very long career, yes, Danny, I know you're gonna say I'm old, but I've had a very long career in golf. I have spent a lot of time over my years working with some of the best players in the world. There are times where I see they can hit anything. They have this God-given talent and they work at it 8 hours a day. They can make things work. If you don't have that time, if you're going out and you're just trying to enjoy the game, you want to enjoy the game. There's things out there that are going to help you play better. There's large titanium woods. There's forgiving irons. There's wedges with bounce and cavities and forgiveness. There's putters with high moment of inertia. They resist twists that you can hit them off the center of the face and you still get good performance. You gotta try that. You know, it's kind of like buying a car. Well, all cars have tires and engines and doors and a steering wheel. They don't perform the same.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. You know, Larry, you touched on tour guys. They want to look for one thing specifically out of ball flight, right?
Absolutely. They're looking at hitting a window, and that's a higher window, a lower window, but they're looking to hit that window with every shot they have because that's what they do for a living. They have to control their yardages to score better, to play better, to make money, to pay the rent, to pay the mortgage.
Yep. So on that side of it, tour guys want to control distance.
Correct.
Flight, right?
Correct.
High handicap guys or gals, we want to kind of control the club face. What's it going to do? If we can get you to miss one way or see one side of the golf course, you know, while you're out playing, that's easier than standing on a tee thinking, Larry, this one might go left, it might go right, or I might hit a career shot. Let's find out, right? We want to narrow that stuff in for players.
Absolutely. I play with some guys, older guys like me, even a little older than me. And one of the guys was, you know, he's like, well, I'm not a really good player. And he's driving the ball about knee high. And I'm like, what are you doing? He goes, well, I just, you know, I'm just struggling and my game's not going to go. I go, do me a favor, come in. We go from a 9-degree driver to a 12-degree driver. I played with him the other day. He's hitting it farther than he's ever hit it. Mm-hmm. And he didn't have to buy a $500 driver. He bought a $250 driver.
Right.
But now he's enjoying the game. Now he's like, I mean, he hit a driver one hole. He turned to me and he's like, oh, I should have done this earlier.
Yeah.
Okay. So we try to make it as relaxed and as easy for you to come in and learn. We're not judging you. What we are is we're evaluating you. We want to see how we can help your game. We're bringing people in here and we want to make you play better. And I'm telling you, you're really losing out on the game and losing out on the enjoyment of the game to not come in and get fit. And again, you know, depending on the level that you want to spend, we can fit you in whatever budget it is.
Absolutely. But one of the misconceptions out there is on the female side of things. Well, should ladies always be playing ladies flex shafts, Larry?
Absolutely not.
Why? Talk to me.
Because the golf club doesn't know whether you're a man, a woman, old, young. Well, it kind of knows I'm old because it doesn't go very fast anymore.
But
it doesn't know that. So when you come in, many times we get players come in and we get female players come in and they're playing the wrong golf club because somebody's passed down a set to them,
right.
That lady set, or I'm using my mom's clubs, or I'm using my aunt's clubs, and they totally don't fit. Right. You know, if you can move the golf ball, if you can swing, we're fitting to that ball speed. We're fitting to that ball flight. So it's kind of irregardless. I mean, I've always talked through the years at the companies I worked for and said the perfect driver fitting would be to have drivers numbered 1 through 12 with no flex and no loft on them, mm-hmm. because all you do is go, "What? Hey, Danny, what did I fit you in today? A number 10. What's a number 10? I don't know what a number 10 is, but that's what I hit the best."
Right.
So, you know, we kind of have to get out of that. We get seniors that come in and they still create a lot of speed. And they think just immediately because they're 65 years old that they need to get a softer shafted golf club. That's totally wrong. So come in and get evaluated. It's not a scary thing.
No.
You know, Danny, myself, everybody else, all the fitters here are here to help you. And it's not something to worry about that, gee, I'm going to kind of embarrass myself. Well, you're not going to embarrass yourself. You're not. It's a fun experience, and you're going to walk out the door, and you're going to be happy, and you're also going to play better golf, and you're going to enjoy it a whole lot more.